my next guest. He made headlines up and down the state. A conservative running for California governor fell short on that, and now he's running to be the California Republican Party chairman. Assemblyman Travis Allen joining us via Skype this week. Always good to see you, sir. Thanks so much for coming on the program.
Thanks so much for having me on. I'm actually in my in-laws' kitchen on Thanksgiving weekend right now.
Well, you're a good man then for being there and for taking time to talk to us. We really do appreciate it. So coming out of the election, sir, there's kind of two narratives that I'm hearing from Republicans here in California. There's one that I'm hearing from people like Kristen Olson, Mike Madrid, and they're saying the GOP in California, it's dead. It's dead. Blow it up. Start it over again. And then I'm also hearing narratives from people like you who say it's not dead. It's struggling. And it's struggling because we've been trying to do the wrong thing for the past few years. Why do you think that is?
Look, this is very clear. This is a crisis of identity from many of the establishment Republicans that have been losing races for two decades in California. What everybody in California has to remember is that back in the mid-90s, Republicans actually had a majority in the California legislature for a short time. Since that point, they have lost election after election, almost every single cycle. And this latest midterm we saw was probably the worst loss of them all. And I will tell you, the answer is very simple. This is because the Republican Party establishment has weakened the party. They have told Republicans that in order to get elected in California, you must look and sound more like Democrats. You know, Republican light, if you will. This sort of thinking, coupled with a lack of statewide voter registration, led to one of the absolute worst midterms we've ever seen in history, which was what we saw just a couple weeks ago.
So when Kristen Olson, who, for people who don't know, she was the former assembly leader, a Republican, when she blames the fact that California Republicans have been unable to detach themselves from national Republican politics, you see it as exactly the opposite, is what I'm hearing.
Without a doubt. Listen, California has more than 5 million Republicans. That's more than any other state in the union. And I will tell you, California Republicans are just as red-blooded as they are across the state. We believe in lower taxes. We believe in the U.S. Constitution. We believe in great schools, safe communities, water in the Central Valley. And you better believe we believe in strong borders and the U.S. president. Unfortunately, there are establishment Republicans, like a couple of the ones you just mentioned, who ripped up their pledges to never raise taxes. That's what Kristen Olson did just a couple of years ago. So now it's no surprise to see these, you know, so-called establishment Republicans calling for the death of the Republican Party. They actually left what we would consider to be the national political scene years ago. And unfortunately, when they left, they took many of the corporate donors with them and the special interests. But I'll tell you what never did leave, and that's the California citizens, the hardworking Californians that believe in everything we talk about, Republican values, Republican ideals, you know, strong families, strong communities. And yes, they're huge fans of our Republican president, who by every single poll is probably the most popular president for Republicans that we've had since Ronald Reagan.
You mentioned voter registration, and it's obviously been bad for Republicans, but also Democrats. They've taken a hit from no party preference as well. It's the no party preference people that has really shot up in the state. So if you get this job, basically in charge of the California Republican Party, I know you talked about raising money. How are you going to bring some of those NPP people over there onto your party specifically?
So what's happened in California is Republicans have lost registrations. No party preference registrations have shot through the roof to where they're the second largest category now. And Democrats have largely just held stable. They didn't really gain, but they didn't lose either. This is because the Democrats have actively, for the last three decades, gone out and registered new voters year on year across the state. The Republicans simply have not done that 4 years, and this is the problem. There are plenty of Republicans. There are a ton of independents that actually vote Republican. To give you an example, in the last 20 years, every single statewide Republican governor candidate has gotten between 38 to 40% of the total California vote, even though Republicans only represent 25% of the voting population in California. So what that means is that people might not be calling themselves Republican, but they're still voting conservatively. So what we really need now is we need a strong Republican Party. We need to rebuild it from the ground up by Republicans for Republicans. We have to go back to the local communities and tell all of our community groups, go out, Talk to your neighbors, talk to your coworkers, talk to your family, register them as Republicans. We need to have a statewide voter registration program again, build up our precincts, build up our communities, because all politics is local. The country club Republicans have forgotten about this for decades, which is why California finds itself in the dire straits it is today. But we cannot have a one-party state in California. Californians deserve to hear both sides, which means we need a strong Republican Party.
So you just finished a big campaign for governor, obviously. That ended in the summer, but are you ready to get out there and start campaigning again? What is this campaign going to look like? Are you going to be traveling while running for chairman?
Absolutely. I'll be up and down the state. Now, remember, when I ran for governor, it was for a very simple reason. I grew up in San Diego, California. I've lived here my whole life. Unfortunately, my parents left the state. They're in Oregon. My brother left the state. He's in Arizona. And my best friends are now over in Texas. But I'm staying here in California because I was born here and I was raised here. This is our state. The way that we take the state back is by going up and down the state to talk to ordinary Californians and tell them that this is who we are. We are Republicans. And you can actually, once again, hold your head high, because not only is it the president, Congress, or at least one of the houses of Congress, and the Supreme Court, but there are plenty of other Republicans right here in California, and you have our support, and we will rebuild your party.
Assemblyman Travis Allen, Assemblyman for a couple more weeks at least, until a new Republican, I should point out, is going to get sworn in early December. We appreciate you taking the time. We wish you the best of luck on this. When you come through the valley, be sure to stop in and say hi.
Evan, you know I will. Let's bring water to the valley, and you better believe, let's take back California.
All right, sir. Thanks so much. Travis Allen joining us here today. Back with the panel right after.